are about to start our Bible study for this evening and prayer session. So I want to just welcome you as you come along and just give God thanks for another evening. And we're looking to God for a great time. So please tune in and enjoy the study tonight. While we listen on, I'm going to start off with the playing of the background song, My Help, from the Brooklyn Tabernacle Choir. Are joining. We're glad that you're on. Minister Young, also Joan Cabinet, glad to have you. Yes, and thanks for your best wishes Sister Cecilia, you have to keep your mic muted until it is time for you to speak, all right? Yes, I want you to pay attention to the study tonight as we look to the Lord for a great time. Amen, amen. We're going to start now. We're going to do just one verse and a chorus of a song to just set the tone for prayer, and then we will move forward in our study. So I want to just greet those who are on tonight. Welcome, Sister Juliette. Welcome, Brother Riley. Good to see you all. And, you know, we just want to fellowship together as a family as we continue to look to God for strength to carry us through in this time. Amen. So we're going to do this song. I am thine, O Lord. Draw me nearer. And then we look to God for prayer.
I am thine, O Lord. I have heard thy voice and adored thy love to be. But I long to rise in the arms of faith and be closer drawn to
Father, we lift you up. We adore you. Lord, we realize that without you, we are nothing. And so even now as we meet in this way, Lord, we ask for your presence to be with us. We ask, Lord, that you will come in all your fullness, that God, you will come and you will touch our hearts, that Lord, you'd cause, oh God, this study to be, oh God, one that will encourage us and one that will lift our spirit. And Lord, we desire you tonight because you are our all and you are, oh God, our God. And so even now, Lord, we want to give you thanks for those who join to listen, oh God, to this study and for those who will share in different ways. I pray, God, that your glory will be felt among us tonight and that, God, you will pour out upon us as you have never done before. Bless us now, O our Savior, because we come to you. And we pray, God, that you just have your way as you have never done before. And help us, O God, that we will give you the honor, the glory, and praise. In Jesus' name, amen. So again, want to welcome those who have joined us for the study already. We are seeing 17 persons online. I want to give a big shout out to Janet McDonald. They're in Cleveland of the USA, joining us. So good to have you. We go way back to Lourdesville days, and you are now overseas and can join in this study tonight. And I want to give God thanks for you. We also have Sister Powell online and her daughter, Shauna Kay. Yes, good to have you. And we also have Sharon French with us. I think she's somewhere in one of those overseas countries. Good to have you. We have Latanya from Canada as well joining. and so many other persons. Chenille. Minister Young, Chenille from New York.
No, London.
From London, Jamaica, right. Chenille Jamaica from Paris. London. Yes, missing her sleep right now to be in this study. So it's really a good thing. And, you know, we want to give God thanks for this opportunity that we have for such a time. And so welcome to one, welcome to all. We have 22 persons online. Yes, I want to welcome those who are on Zoom as well. Sister Farron has joined. And for those of you who have the link for Zoom, please get onto the Zoom connection, because later on in the study, we would like you to share with us, interact with us. So if you can get onto Zoom, that would be great. Welcome Howard Wright, my schoolmate and friend from Lloydsville. Yes, good to have you with us tonight as we study God's Word. Tonight we want to continue with the study of 1 Peter chapter 2, as we said last week, and we're going to be looking at verses 11 through 17, and our focus tonight is living before the world and submission to government. Now, these are two important things, how we live among the world today and also how we submit to the rulership and the authority of our government. And Rakar Williams, my son, will be joining to read for us tonight the scriptures from 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 11 through 17. And for those of you who have your Bibles, please follow while he reads. Amen.
Dearly beloved, I beseech you as strangers and pilgrims, abstain from fleshly lusts, which war against the soul, having your conversation honest among the Gentiles, that whereas they speak against you as evildoers, they may by your good works, which they shall behold, glorify God in the day of visitation. Submit yourself to every ordinance of man for the Lord's sake, whether it be to the king as supreme, or unto governors as unto them that are sent by him for the punishment of evildoers, and for the praise of them that do well. For so is the will of God, that with well doing ye may put to silence the ignorance of foolish men, as free, and not using your liberty for a cloak of maliciousness, but as the servants of God. 17 and last, honor all men, love the brotherhood, fear God, honor the king.
Amen. Bless the Lord. I want to give God thanks for his word tonight, and thank you, Rickard, for reading for us. I want to just continue to give a shout out to those who are on. I see Messaline, my cousin in Canada, joining us. Yes, Messaline, Janet McDonald is online as well. So we are in for a good treat tonight. Persons from all over that are online. Yes, Pastor Gail from Goshen, Clarendon, and Chavelle can make out all of this. Sage, purpose driven. Yes, good to have you online with us tonight. And we are moving right into the study, and we trust that you will really just open up to the Lord as he leads tonight. I also want to make it known for those, our model friends, that model Church of God friends, that Janet McDonald is a cousin of Pollyanna Lunan. So we are in a small world, you know. Her passing has caused us to meet up in this way and for Janet to get access to me tonight. So we want to give God thanks for that. You know, nothing happens by chance. And so we look to him for his guidance, his leading, for such a time. So welcome to one, welcome to all, and we're going to go straight into the study, and we trust that you will enjoy the moment. So we're focusing on, you know, living before the world and submission to God. Last week we talked about building our spiritual muscle, which is, you know, building our capacity to endure the challenges that comes in this crisis and that we face from time to time. But this week now, I want to look at how we are to live before the world and also how we submit to the government. Because in these crises, sometimes the way we live as people who are hopeless. Sometimes we live so ungodly, and the decisions we make cause others to look down on us as Christians. So we have to be careful in the midst of our crises. In the midst of the crisis, we must demonstrate where our source lies, because our source lies in the living God. So in this global pandemic, we realize that even some churches are very tempted to disobey the guidance that is set by the government. And some could also do it out of misunderstanding or lack of knowledge for not hearing the directives that were given. Or some could just be deliberate in what they do. But as Christians, we are called to be light. We are called to set examples. And that's what we want to look at tonight. The guidelines that are given to the government is really to help to save lives and to protect us. And so we must ensure that as best as possible, we cooperate with these directives and realize that it is a way of helping to protect ourselves as well as to help to protect our fellow men. So the guidelines, they include reduction in the number of persons who can gather for worship. It involves, you know, no handshaking and no closeness as we are accustomed to. There must be maintenance of social distancing. At one point it was 3 feet, now it is 6 feet. And so we must be mindful of that. We are also encouraged to wear our mask. I heard one young man tell me that, Rev, I'm not going to wear any mask. And so when we gather for funeral on Saturday, I was looking forward to see if he would have been there without his mask to send him home. But lo and behold, he was in his mask. So there are those who will make comments, but when it comes to the test, they fall in line. So we want to look to God tonight to help us that we will really do our part in this trying time. The experts have made these suggestions, and even sometimes we don't see the relevance of it. But because the experts give the instruction, we have to try to comply as best as possible. There's no harm in following the directives, doing what is required, so that, you know, we don't be an hindrance to somebody else contracting the virus, and we don't cause ourselves to get caught in the middle of it. So that's part of what we need to be mindful of. The Zoom line is shared on Facebook for those who would like to connect with us through Zoom. Minister Williams, my wife, Joy Roberts Williams, she has just shared that. So you can get that link if you wish and join on Zoom as well. So I want to thank you for staying with us. These guidelines, they affect our religious freedom. We really can't go to church and worship the way we used to, and we don't worship in the numbers that we used to. But I'm glad that this has created a new opportunity for us to meet in this way. And in the past, we would have had our few persons at Bible study tonight, but now I can engage my aunt from Lloydersville, Eulalie Johnson. Yes, my cousin Messaline in Canada. We can engage Janet McDonald in Cleveland, USA. We can engage Chanel from the UK. We can engage Cosmo, Latanya from Canada, and Sadie from Canada, and all our friends here from Jamaica, Minister Young, Minister Adams, yes, Sister Powells and Shauna Kay, and others who are on. So this creates a new opportunity. And so when we would have only have a few Jamaicans meeting, now we have foreigners in the mix, listening to what God has to say. And so this is a great, great opportunity. So we want to bear that in mind. And the good thing is that, you know, even our Sunday services, we can share them live. So you could perhaps be home doing your chores and still worshiping along. And so, you know, we give God thanks for that, because it could have been otherwise, where we are home for days or months and we cannot hear anything and we cannot socialize or engage with each other. But the opportunity is here, and we want to give God thanks for that. Even now we see Elaine joining us from Canada. And so this has created a new opportunity. And even in the midst of it, and even in our, you know, want to complain and so on, we can give God thanks that there are some positive things happening because of this system that we are going through. So as a people, we are accustomed to socializing and hugging and shaking hands, but we are in a time where we have to desist from doing that for our own health and welfare, for our own safety. And so, you know, we must be mindful of that. We need to realize that it is best as possible to conform to these mandates, to these guidelines, because what the Word of God tells us is that rebellion is as the sin of witchcraft. And so as Christians, we don't want to be named among those who are rebellious and, you know, hard to deal with and hard to follow instructions and hard to cooperate. We have to work along with our government because, you know, we are all in this thing together. We all want to see the protection of our people. We want to see lives being spared. And so we must work together. And this lesson tonight is not just about because of COVID. We are also looking at the issue of the USA. They are now going into their election mode. And Jamaica is one less than a year away from another general election. So we need to bear these things in mind as a country, as a people, as we, you know, we don't want to be so caught up and heavily minded that we serve no purpose to the earth. So we must be of good and of value to the earth as well, just as how we want to get to heaven. So as Christians, we don't want to be named among those who are rebellious and uncooperative. We don't want to bring any shame to the name of Jesus. And so we must learn how to conduct ourselves. We must learn how to model Christ in our lives, in this crisis and in our day-to-day operation. So what does the Bible say to us? And in the midst of this crisis, how should we really conduct ourselves? When we look on, we realize that there's so much happening around the world, and sometimes what is happening elsewhere, we are not encountering it. But if it is happening elsewhere and people are suffering, then as Christians, we ought to be concerned. And so from the Word of God, looking at verse 11, it says to us that we are pilgrims and strangers in this world. So our real home is really heaven. But as we are here, there's so much that we need to do. There's so much attention that we need to give to how we live. And so for us, heaven is where our God lives. And heaven is governed by God's principles and values. And his domain, it cannot be shaken. And so tonight, I want us to be mindful of that. Praise the Lord. So the Word has challenged us that we must abstain from sinful desires. And if we really want to make it into heaven, we have to abstain from the sinful desires. And also when we get enticed and indulge in the sinful action, what we do is let down our guard. What we do is let people look on. People look on us in a negative way. So we have to be mindful of that. For those who are on Zoom, please remember to mute your mic until it is time for you to engage us. All right, thank you much. So the whole point is we want to get to heaven. We have to abstain from sinful practices. We have to do what God requires us to do. But at the same time, when we are not living the life, when we are getting involved and indulging in sinful practices, it causes their trust in us. It causes others to see Christianity in a negative light. And so as believers, you and I have a responsibility to be mindful of how we live, because our role as Christian is to win others for Christ. You know, when we accept Christianity, we have accepted a responsibility to win others for Christ. And so we now have to live in a way that our lives will draw others to Christ. So when the crisis faces us, we cannot give up. We cannot live hopeless. We cannot live like how the world would live. We cannot do the things as how the world will. We are naturally tempted to do it because we are human. But we must always keep our eyes on Christ. We must be focused that, listen, if I don't live the way that God expects me to live, then others will lose hope. Others will be distracted. Others will look on our faith in a negative way. And so you and I must do what we must do in order to win Christ in the situation, in order for God to get glory out of this situation. And so That's the first point that we need to realize. The next point we want to look at is that our behavior and our action, it must be above reproach. Must be above reproach. And this helps to draw others to Christ. So here Peter, he was speaking to believers who were scattered abroad, you know, scattered in various places among many unbelieving Gentiles. And these people did not believe in God. And so when Peter spoke to the believers, you know, he was speaking to them at a time where there are many persons who are ready to criticize them, who are ready to believe the lies that were being spoken about Christians. And this is no different from now, right? If one person says something negative about Christianity, something perhaps is the first they are hearing it, others are willing to accept it and believe it, and we know that it could be a lie. So, you know, a different time when we look at it. And so we have to try to live above reproach so that, you know, the way, if we are even criticized, when you assess the facts, you will realize that we are not wrong. So we must be, you know, be mindful of that. We must ensure that, you know, the rumors that will come, that we are not guilty of it. And so that in these situations, others can find, you know, that we are in the truth and be led to wanting to serve our Lord and our Savior. We have to show people that Christ is our hope. We have to show people that Christ dwells in us. And so whatever negatives that will be said about us, people will, there are those who will look on and can say that no, it is not so, because they can prove that we are living the way God wants us to live. So here it is a test for us in verse 11 and verse 12 of 1 Peter chapter 2, you know, that we have to learn how to live among our fellow men. We have to learn to model Christ in this trying time, in this crisis and beyond. We must, as Christians, set the example. So we are to be models wherever we work, wherever our school is. We're as Christians in our church, we must be good example. In the community in which we live, we are called to model Christ. And so let us be an example wherever we go. The next segment that I want to look at is in verses 13 through 17, which Peter speaks to the believers about how to submit to government. And this is not saying that we're going to compromise our faith and our belief, but here Peter wants us to know that we must obey the laws of the land. And Peter, as we look in Acts chapter 5, verse 29, he was a man who says that it is better to obey God rather than man. So Peter is not encouraging us that we must give all honor to man and ignore our God. But Peter wants us to know that there is a place for us in honoring, you know, the laws of the land. And when we do that, it is an important thing to do. When we look at it during COVID, as the onset of it in Jamaica, there were people who made the news about, you know, defiance and failing to follow the orders and so on. And for us, some of it, it was very hilarious. But at the same time, we as Christians, we find ourselves doing some of those similar things, just that we are not caught. And we don't want our behavior to become hilarious and to make headlines about how we behave. So we must submit to the laws of the land, and we must submit to the government. Praise God. What Peter is encouraging us is that in all aspects of our daily lives, it is, once it is possible, right, we must try to live according to the laws of the land. This is something that is encouraged, and we must aim to do it, because in everything that we do, we want to please our God. We realize some countries, they don't have the freedom that we have to be able to worship and to move about, you know, and they are under some duress. But tonight we have the freedom where we can lift up Jesus Christ even in our homes, and we can open our windows and we can pray. There's no law there that binds us and prevents us from being able to give worship to God. And so we are in a good place tonight. And for that, we want to give God the glory and the praise. But Peter also wants to say to us that we are to cooperate with the rulers. Yes, for as far as our conscience allows us, right? If in obeying the government we feel that we are doing something wrong, then you know we must know to look to the Lord as to what decisions must and steps that we must take, because we want to ensure that we please God in what we are doing. And so as much as we can cooperate, let us do that. We are to do this for the Lord's sake. We are to do it for the Lord's sake, so that his good news and his people will be respected. So if we reach to a point where we are disregarding the laws of the land, you know, people will not look on us in a positive way, and people will not respect us as believers. And so, you know, we must realize that we respect the laws of the land so that we can garner the respect from those who lead the land. So bear that in mind. And if we are persecuted, it should be for obeying God. When we are persecuted, it should be for obeying God. It should not be for us breaking any moral law or any civil law. So we need to bear that in mind. So as Christians, we have an awesome responsibility. The Word of God tells us that we must let our light so shine before men that they may see our good works and be led to glorify our Father which is in heaven. So I want to encourage us that we must, you know, get to that point of obeying, because obedience is better than sacrifice. Amen. When we look at or we look at government, there's mixed views as believers, mixed views. And you know, some persons prefer one party, one political party versus the other. And you are free to do that. And there's no one should force you to decide which side you should support. You know, we must be responsible, you know, we make our choice and what views we support as a people. But there are mixed views about government. One is that some people think that the government is so corrupt that as Christians we should have nothing to do with government. But those same people will live as good citizens as long as they can without compromising their beliefs. So nothing is wrong in that person's view. This is how they see it. And they will not work for the government. They will not vote in an election. And they will not serve in the military. That's their view about it. The second view is that there are those who believe that God has given the government the authority in certain areas, and that the church has authority in other areas. So these Christians, they will be loyal to both the government and they will be loyal to their Christian faith, and they can work on both sides. But the key thing is that they do not confuse both. They know the place, both has its own place. And so church and government are concerned about two totally different things. One is concerned about the spiritual, and one is concerned about the physical. And thus, they complement each other, but they do not work together. There are those who have that view. And then the third is that Christians have a responsibility to make the government better. And so they do this politically by voting for those who are Christian leaders and for those who have high principled, those who are high principled leaders. And they can also do this morally by serving as an influence of good to the society. So there are those who will offer themselves to serve because they see it as a way to help to bring a change to the government. And so the church and the government, they ideally work together for the good of all. So these are three different perspectives. And within this mix, even tonight, there are those who will hold one view or the other. But none of these advocate a rebellion against refusing to obey the government or the laws of the land. So whatever posture you take from these three different perspectives, none of them promote or advocate that we must rebel against the laws of the land. So unless those laws are clearly, you know, going to violate our Christianity or our moral standards, that's the only time we will be thinking about pulling back or disobeying those laws. So wherever we find ourselves as believers, we are called to be responsible citizens. We are called to be good examples as Christians. And we must remember that we are free from keeping the law as a way to earn salvation. But we do keep the laws of the land because it's a way of giving gratitude for the freedom of salvation that we have. And when we look even at the Ten Commandments as it is taught, it is an expression of God's will for us. And so, you know, we are called to obey. And the great commission that God has given us, you know, it tells us that the law is fulfilled in this great commandment, that we must love God with all our heart, our soul, our mind, our strength, and we are to love our neighbors as ourselves. So tonight, this is a charge to us, that in being good fellow citizens, we must demonstrate this great commission of the Lord, which is to love God with all our hearts, mind, soul, and strength, and to love our neighbors as ourselves. So as we look at 1 Peter tonight, we realize from this in summary that every born again Christian, for the sake of Christ, we are subject to every human institution as we live in this world. We are servants of the living God, and He gives us the encouragement that we must obey the laws of the land, because it is the will that God has for us. It is His will for us to do that. And we are also commanded to keep our conduct among our fellow believers honorable. People must look on us and see us as good models, modeling Christianity, modeling Christ in the way we live. So that when people speak against us as evildoers, such as when we have ignored the government mandates, or during this pandemic, which is affecting so many lives across the world, and it is killing some persons, it is destroying some families. The very upkeep, or we're going to care for our family, is in question, because many are losing jobs. But in the midst of this, how does the Christian react? How does the Christian conduct him or herself? We want people to look on and see that our deeds are good, that we are obeying the law, and that we are honoring those who are set as rulers over us, so that it will silence the godless, those who are criticizing us. It will silence them, and then it will give glory to God for, you know, on the day of His return, that we have done our part and we have done well. So tonight, in applying this study to our lives, we are at a time where we should not be reckless or irresponsible in how we live our lives. We must realize that there are lives at stake. And so, you know, we can't go about and risk. Even though we think that we are good, the encouragement is that we must treat it that everybody is a suspect, everybody has the virus, and be responsible in how we live, in how we move throughout, you know, our interaction with each other. And just because the church is not meeting as usual, it doesn't mean that we are forsaking ourselves. It doesn't mean that we are neglecting to meet. Because with the church not being open, there are other opportunities that have been created so that we can, you know, we can engage with each other and we can be blessed. For tonight, I think it's 6 p.m., we should be off the street. Yes, but yet we can be up in the Word, up fellowshipping, sharing together. And this, I want to say thanks to the living God.
Amen.
There are many ways to encourage one another as to help in the prevention of the spread of the virus. We are now at a time where it says that we are at the community stage where, you know, we can have an outbreak in a community, just as how we have seen the outbreak in a, in institution and how many numbers have been affected. It's a similar way that a community can be, you can have an outbreak in a community. And so we have to pray against that, and we have to do our part, you know, to help in preventing the spread. And as believers, we must be examples. So, you know, whatever is happening around us that is not ideal, that is not advisable, we must speak out against it, because we are in this thing together and we are in the light. And because we are in the light, we have to be the one that will show those who are in the darkness that, listen, the way you are doing it and the approach you are taking, it is wrong. Praise the Lord. And so we can encourage others in this time, you know, through calls. We can encourage people. For us, we have our church WhatsApp group, and we are now engaging through Facebook and Zoom. You can share in these medium. Give your words of encouragement. Give your prayer. And listen to the concerns of others and pray for them as they will share in this time. So I want to thank you for, you know, this time and this study tonight as we have engaged. And I don't see much persons on Zoom, right? But we're still opening up for those to join us that we can interact at this time. But the challenge to us tonight is, as fellow believers, how do we conduct ourselves in such a time? Are we being good examples to those around us? Are we just throwing up, you know, putting our hands in the air and our hands and our head as if we are hopeless and saying, how am I to survive? How can I make it? If you have lost your job, you know, are you becoming desperate and wanting to give up and thinking how to seek your bread in desolate places? We have got to take stock tonight. Amen. We have to be, and I want to say also in this time, we have to let go of pride. Because if you are home hungry and you refuse to, you know, seek help even from your church, and you stay in your desperate stage and nobody knows that you are suffering, you are not wise. This is a time where we have to draw on the living God for help and support. And the word of God says that we must knock and it shall be open. We must ask and it shall be given. We must seek and it shall be, and we shall find. And I want to challenge us as believers that in our seeking and our knocking, in our searching, don't go in the wrong direction. Don't go to the beggarly elements. Don't go to the wrong source. Your church is supposed to be one of your first point of contact. You know, how can the church help you in this time? Your fellow brothers and sisters must be the place that you're going to turn to. Your family members who are able to help you, you can turn to them. Yes, and the government has opened up ways, you know, to give support. But you know that that's a red tape and a bureaucratic procedure. And in trying to get help, we have to endure those challenges, because, you know, you want help, you have to seek it. And as it is said in our culture, if you want good, your nose have to run. So, you know, just to get the support from government, you have to apply, you have to wait, you have to make sure you meet all the requirements and so on. But that's normal, right? But we are also saying that in this time, you are going to be challenged. When you are, when your family is around you and you are going through your struggles and you can't find your way out, you're going to be, your faith is going to be tested. In this time, how does the member, the Christian conduct him or herself? This is something that we must pay attention to, because we want to ensure that in this time, God gets glory. We want to remember that he's our source of survival. We want to remember that, you know, he's our provider, and that he says in his word he will supply all our needs according to his riches in glory. So I want to challenge us tonight that whatever is happening in our individual lives, let us look to the Lord. Let us be an example. Let us, you know, draw on the Lord right, in prayer, because it's in this time that we need him now more than ever. And we want the way that we live will cause those around us who are hopeless, those who are discouraged, those who are giving up, to realize that there is a God. And they can draw strength on him tonight. So, in the midst of this time, draw on the Lord. How does the Christian react when we are infected with the COVID, or we are sick from other ailments and don't know how to manage? How should we really respond? You know, we are at a crisis, and I want to encourage us that as believers, our faith must be strong. As believers, we must not give up. As believers, we must demonstrate that we have God on our side, and let people see the light in us and be led to glorify the Lord. So Minister Young says sometimes the waiting process will be long, but let us hold on. So, you know, as she said, if you apply through the government for help, the waiting process may be long, but hold on. But also, as you wait on the Lord to carry us through this process, it may be long, but we've got to hold on. We've got to keep our faith in the Lord. We've got to keep our heads above the water. We've got to trust in the Lord with all our hearts. And, you know, lean not unto our own understanding. In all our ways, we have to acknowledge him, and he shall direct our path. Still encouraging some of you to join us on Zoom so we can get some vocal interaction. I want to hear your voice tonight. Amen. We have Sister Cecile, so I'm going to open up in a minute for Sister Cecile to share, you know, just in a minute, Sister Cecile. So prepare your thoughts as you will join us. Want to just welcome those who are on. Some of you have some persons have come on and have left, and others keep joining. So want to give God thanks for you. Makisha Bembridge, who have joined us. Yes, and for Sharon French, who have been online for a good while. Yes, it's sometimes it's your comment will let me know that you are online. So it's good to see you. So those who are online, just start give your amen. Sister Juliette, yes, I see Akeem Brown. Welcome. I know Rochelle is studying, having a class, and she's still online with us. So I want to give God thanks for that. Yes. Continue to share your amens so I know who is online. Bless the Lord. Amen. Right. And as I said, I'm encouraging you to join us on Zoom. So welcome to one. Welcome to all. Thank you for staying tuned. And at this time, I'm going to be opening up for Sister Cecile. Sister Cecile?
Those yes, sir.
Okay. The video, let me thought you weren't hearing me. All right. Based on the study tonight, you know, as Christians, we have to set example for the world. And we also have a responsibility to be obedient to our government and the laws of our land. So I'm opening up for you to just give me your perspective on that tonight, what stands out for you, and what encouragement you can give to those who are listening on from Facebook. Before you share, I want to welcome Highlight Award again. And we also realize that Roden Baker has joined us. So I want to thank God for you. Right. So Sister Cecile, give me your views and your encouragement to those who are listening on.
Go ahead, Sister Cecile.
Sister Cecile?
She's not hearing.
All right. So Sister Cecile not hearing. So we want to, just move on.
Oh, she's yes. Not hearing clearly.
Right. Not hearing clearly. So want to give God thanks for those who are on tonight. We are almost at the end of our study, but I really wanted us to have the interaction and to hear other person's perspective. But I just, my study focused a lot about Jamaica. But when you think about what is happening in the USA, in Canada, in the UK, you too as believers, you sometimes your system of government is even a little different from ours. And some things that are done in your country, you know, it's hard for you to accept it, because you know that when you were back home in Jamaica, things were different and you were not subject to certain things that you may have to take on when you are overseas. So, but overall, as believers, we have to be mindful of this. And whichever place that we are placed to live and to survive, we have to be a good example. So if God placed us in Canada, we have to learn the laws of Canada and follow that. If God placed us in the USA, we are expected to learn the laws of the USA and, you know, conform. If we are in the UK, we've got to learn the laws of UK and conform. So wherever we are, we have to understand the custom, the culture. As the word of God says, you give unto Caesar what is due unto Caesar, right? And to give unto God the things which are God, our God. So tonight, as we look at it, you know, it's something for us to pay attention to. As Christians, there are some of us who we're really not mindful about, you know, government. We are just all thinking about our God and making sure that we please God. But we must realize that when we fail to please our leaders who are set above us, what we are doing is dishonoring our God, because our God has given us the mandate that we must be obedient, you know, to the rule that is set over us. And so we want to pay attention to that. Amen. 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 I realize Sister Ferron is online. Sister Ferron? On Zoom. Want to be, if you are able to hear us, we'd love you to share. Yeah, Sister Ferron? Sister Ferron?
The Zoom not working tonight,
right? Right, the Zoom not picking up right. So we just have to work with our Facebook tonight. So I want to give God thanks that, you know, in everything, we realize that the systems around us, they don't last forever. And they will fail us from time to time. But in every situation, our God, he promises that he will never, never fail us. He's always with us. And that's why we must ensure that, you know, we live in a way that people will value our God and give him honor, because they will see from our lives that, yes, God is worthy to be praised. Amen. And so tonight I want to encourage us to bear that in mind. Praise God. Praise God. So we're coming close to the end. We want to move into prayer. If there's any prayer requests, please send them momentarily. Please send them while we are closing and moving towards prayer. Yes. And I just want to thank you for staying the course with us tonight. And I really miss the interaction and to hear your voices. But, you know, the Lord is with us tonight and he's here to bless and to do us good. Praise God. So Sister Cecile is saying that in everything, it's a season. Yes. So there's a season for COVID, and that season will soon be ended. Janet McDonald is saying that there's no excuse wherever we are, and God's grace is sufficient to keep us. So wherever we are, there's no excuse. We must be obedient, you know, and follow the laws as we are required, and realize that God's grace is sufficient to keep us. He's able to keep us through the COVID virus, and he's able to keep us beyond. It is said that the same grace that has kept us this far, one songwriter, is the same grace that will lead us on. And so we draw on his grace tonight, that is able to sustain us and to help us along. Christians are the salt. Yes, Reverend French, you should have been online to give us this word. Christians are the salt and the light in the world, as well as in this present crisis. So, believers, this study really is to tell us that, listen, we cannot take COVID like how the world does. We cannot behave with treat COVID like how everybody else do it. We have to represent Christ in how we do it, because we want God to get glory out of this time, out of this season, out of how we live. Amen. You know, and when there are those who are hopeless, all when you have the virus, you must be willing to find a way to pray for others and help them to know that even though I have the situation, I have to be strong for others. Yes. And so Evangelist Bloomfield is asking for prayer for herself and her family. So we want to remember that tonight. Amen. That's our first prayer request I'm seeing. I don't know if there's others. Do you see any other, John?
No.
Right. So want to remember Sharon tonight. And prayer is never too much, evangelist. And we continue to pray your strength, you know. It's a time of uncertainty and so much is happening, but God's grace is sufficient. Yes, Sharon. God's grace is sufficient. His grace is sufficient to see us through. And indeed, God's grace is able to help you as well, Sister Sharon, as you go through your different challenges. Yes, he's able to help you. Amen. Amen. Bless the Lord. Praise God. Where Rakar is, I want him to play a song for me. Rakar?
Rakar.
I want you to play. We're going to do a song, and then we're going to be moving into prayer. So I want you to bear with us as we are coming close to the end. Yes, and Rev is still sharing in a man. Rev, you should be on Zoom. The world is looking to the church for help and encouragement in the midst of the varied problems. Yes, and sometimes, Rev, you remember when they... I remember when one security minister said we need divine intervention. People looked on him in a negative way. But then when it reached COVID, the governor general called prayer. Because this is a time where, you know, we realize we need the Lord now more than ever. So sometimes as a people, we treat prayer, we accept prayer when we think it's necessary. But the word of God says we must pray without ceasing. So prayer is suitable for every condition, whether you're in your good times or your bad times. And as Christians, we must model that. We must let people know that prayer is the key. And so in this crisis, we need prayer. But outside of the crisis, we are going to need prayer. Amen? Yes, Rev. Glad that you agree with me. Right. Sister Juliet is also asking for prayer. And also Brother Akeem Brown is asking for prayer. Amen. Amen. So we want to, you know, bring you before the Lord tonight because he's able. For you, I am praying. For you, I am praying. For you, that we must not wait until trouble. Yes, don't wait until there's trouble. Let us continue to draw our strength from the living God. Continue to call upon him now while he may be found. Amen. And I see a request from Veronica Swaby. Prayer request for her son. Want to remember him tonight and want to just greet you, Veronica, as you are with us tonight. Also, I'd seen Beverly Swaby joining us. Yes, want to give God thanks for you tonight. Amen. And for those who are on Zoom, yes, Evangelist Bloomfield, yes, want to give God thanks for you. Zoom wasn't working well earlier, but you know, as we are here tonight, want to give God thanks and just hope that you are able to hear us clearly. So at this time, I'm going to take, you know, just bring these requests before the Lord and just trust that he will help his people at such a time. Father, we lift you up tonight. We adore you because you are the King of Kings and you are the Lord of Deliverer. You are the mighty God. You are our help, O God, in the present, in our crisis. You, O God, are our hope. You are our strength, strength like no other. And even now, mighty God, we declare that you are Lord. We declare that you are Lord in this season. We declare, Lord, that you are our help. We declare, Lord, that you are the deliverer from COVID and from every problem at this time. We declare, Lord, that there is no God like Jehovah. You are the King of kings and the Lord of lords. You are mighty in battle. You are mighty, O God. And though there are so much uncertainty around us, though there are so much concerns, Lord, we can draw strength on you tonight. And so, God, even as we meet through this social media, want to thank you, God, for those who are listening on. Want to thank you, God, for those who are sharing from near and far. Those, oh God, in the UK, oh God, for Chanel, who has wake up from her sleep to join us even at this time. We want to give God, give you the thanks, mighty God. And we pray for your favor upon her. We pray for your blessing upon her. We pray, God, that you would work out your purpose in her life tonight. Help her, God, that she will come to a place to be a good example, oh God, wherever she is and wherever you will place her, mighty God. I pray that you would open up opportunities for her as you have never done before. And show her, God, that you are with her and that, God, you have called her for such a time. I pray for those in Canada tonight, for Sadie, for Elaine, for Latanya. Oh, God, those who have joined us tonight, Joan. Yes, God, I place them in your hands tonight, mighty God. And I pray, God, that you would work your purpose in their lives. There's nothing too hard for you to do, great God. And so, God, I bundle them before you and I ask for your blessing upon their lives. I ask for your help in this time. Oh, God, I pray that you would edge them in and that you would make the ways when there seems to be no way. We pray for those, oh, God, in the USA. Oh, God, for Janet in Cleveland. Yes, Lord, I place her in your hands tonight. Oh, God, and for others who I may have missed their names, for the Swabies, Lord, I put them in your hands tonight. Yes, and I pray for your favor, oh God, and your blessings to be poured out upon them, to be multiplied. Yes, oh Lord. God, I pray, Lord, that you would restore unto them everything that they have lost, oh God, and every disappointment that the enemy will try to bring, oh God, to their territory. We disturb them tonight and we claim, oh God, that your plans and your will be done in their lives as never before. So God, we place those from the US in your hands. Yes, God, I also remember Messaline, I'm from Canada, who have tuned in. Lord, I pray that you would just be her portion tonight. I pray, God, that you will show up in her circumstances and that you will help her to know that you are God. I put Sharon French in your hands tonight, mighty God. Yes, and I pray that you will prove yourself as never before. Oh God, whatever she's going through, I pray, God, that you will be her strength and that, God, she will be able to trust you and see you at work, Lord, in her life tonight. Oh God, for those of us who are here in Jamaica, yes, we bundle everyone before you tonight. Yes, God. Minister Adams, Minister Young, yes, God, and all. Oh, Reverend French, and for everyone who is on, Brother Riley, we put them on before you tonight, mighty God. They have not asked for a prayer request tonight, but God, we know that you are able and there's nothing too hard for you to do. So we pray, Lord, that your hands will be heavily laid on them tonight and that, God, you just pour out upon them as you have never done before. Yes, for those who have asked, oh God, for prayers tonight, Evangelist Bloomfield, oh God, for her family. Lord, this is such a discouraging time. But Lord, as the word has come tonight to encourage us that we must be example, oh God, to the world, because the world is looking on us, oh God, for leadership. The world is looking on us, oh God, for the light. And so I pray, Lord, for the strength of Sister Sharon and her family, that, God, they will not break under the pressure, oh God, but that they will continue to keep their eyes upon you. Yes, we are praying that you will intervene in their circumstances, Lord, and that you break every plan, oh God, of the enemy over their lives. I pray, God, that you lift up a standard tonight against the enemy, and that, God, you would pour out your power and your majesty, oh God, in a marked way. You will demonstrate that you are on their side. side. Yes, God, and that they will not be destroyed. Oh, God, so I pray for their health tonight. I pray for their finances. I pray, oh, God, that you'd lift them up, that you'll give them the strength to endure. I pray, oh, God, that you'll show up in their circumstances and you'll prove to them, Lord, that you are their God. I pray, God, that you'll help them to weather their storm. I pray, God, that you'd help them, oh, God, that they will be good example. Yes, God, and though around them there are those who are falling, help them to stand. Help them to stand. Help them to stand, Lord, and to be an example. So even now, I pray for a fresh outpouring of your Holy Spirit that will give them comfort and strength and wisdom in this time. Oh, God, and that you would make the way for them and help them, Lord, to be gracious and to give you the praise and the honor in Jesus' name. We lift up Sister Cecile before you tonight. We lift up Sister Ferran. We lift up Sister Powell and Shauna Kay. Oh, God, as they share with us tonight, we pray, Lord, that you would be, oh, God, their help and that, God, you would cover them under your blood and that, oh, God, you would just be there to just provide and sustain them in this trying time. Oh, God, and we give you thanks for them tonight. Want to lift up Brother Akeem before you. Lord, whatever he has, his needs are, you will understand. And so, God, I place him in your hands tonight. I pray, God, that you'd help him, oh, God, to be an example. That, God, he will draw on your strength tonight. I pray, God, that all the trials and the testing that he faces, that, God, he will prove you as his living God. Yes, Father, we pray, Lord, that you'd continue to watch over him. Let God, you'd continue to be there for him. And help him, oh, God, that he will draw closer and closer to you. Father, you know his desire tonight. You know that he loves you. And many times he failed you, mighty God. But tonight, mighty God, I pray that you'll be his help, Lord, and that you draw him closer to you. Help him not to give up at this time, but that, God, he will draw on your strength. He will draw on that last thread of hope and that he will continue, Lord, to press on with you. Bless him tonight. I pray, Lord, that he'll continue, Lord, as he continues to be useful in your kingdom. That, God, you will richly reward him. And that, God, he will never seek his bread in desolate places. Yes, God, open up to him tonight. Oh, God, and bless his mother and his family in a marked way as we place them in your hands and give you thanks for the victory in Jesus' name. Father, I want to place Sister Juliet before you tonight. I pray, God, that you continue to just be her portion. Continue to be, oh, God, her guide. Continue, oh, God, to help her. Bless her health tonight, mighty God. Lord, and just give her strength to endure. Yes, God, I pray, Lord, that every ear of her body will function as you have caused it to. And Lord, that it will not malfunction in the name of Jesus. We declare good health upon her tonight. And we declare strength in the name of Jesus. We pray that her household will be blessed. That her children will be saved in this season. And that, God, you'd cause Sister Juliet to be an example in her home and wherever she is. Yes, God, and as a woman of prayer, that she will not weaken her stance in this time, but she will continue to call upon you, mighty God, and she will continue to pray. Answer her prayers tonight, God, as she continues to pray for her family, oh God, and give her the desires of her heart in this season. We declare it done in the mighty name of Jesus, and we give you thanks for her, Lord, in Jesus' name. Father, I want to lift up Veronica Swaby before you tonight. And we pray, God, that you will edge her in and that you'll touch her, oh God, and that you'll show yourself strong in her life tonight. Father, we're praying, oh God, that you'd open up, oh God, in every ear of her life and prove yourself that you are our God. Father, there's nothing impossible for you, mighty God. So you know the challenges that she goes through. And so we bundle her challenges in your hands tonight, mighty God. And we claim victory in the name of Jesus for Veronica. Father, she has asked for prayer for her son tonight, mighty God. You understand the crisis that we are going through. The children are so disoriented. The children, oh God, are at a time where they are so concerned and they are wondering if they are going to be able to exceed and to excel. But God, we are declaiming victory tonight for Veronica's son and for all the children, oh God, who are so concerned about their exams. Yes, God, we bundle them before you tonight. Even Rochelle, who is preparing, oh God, for exams. Oh Lord, and for the changes that that the children have to go through with the online learning. Lord, it is such a challenge for some of them. Some homes don't even have computers. Oh God, and the children are at a disadvantage. But God, as Veronica has asked for prayer for her son, I pray, Lord, that every challenge will be resolved tonight. Yes, God, and you'd work out your purposes in his life in a marked way, and that, God, he will excel. Lord, you call us to be the head and not the tail. And so, God, I declare him blessed tonight. I declare wisdom beyond sight tonight. I declare, oh God, that you will prove yourself to him, mighty God, and that he will come out victorious. Oh God, so we seal him tonight under your blood, and we claim victory in his CXE results, in his C-sex results. Oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus, we pray that everything will become clear and everything will become plain, that God would open up his wisdom, his intellect. Oh God, his knowledge base, oh God, will be expanded tonight. His capacity will be soaked with knowledge, oh God, and wisdom. And he will find, oh God, a change in his heart, in his life tonight. And I pray, God, that as you show up in his life, and as you prove yourself, Lord, to him, that God, in response, he will give you his all. He will give you total obedience, oh God, and he will just surrender all to you. So we bless him tonight, mighty God. And we pray, God, that you will just continue to order his steps and work with him, oh God, from this day forth until he has completed every exam. And we declare victory and success in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
And for all the children of Model Church, all the young people, oh God, who are so trying to get adjusted to the changes, oh God, and they're really concerned about their performance and their progress, mighty God, and we bundle them before you, and we pray for their help tonight. We pray, Lord, that you grant them success, and that, God, every challenges will be resolved. Yes, God, you would open up to them a new knowledge and wisdom, and that, God, they will give you glory and honor and praise.
Yes,
in the name of Jesus. Bless the parents at this time.
Yes,
some are challenged, oh God, even because we are doing homeschooling, but the school still requires their school fee, and this becomes a challenge. Some of us are at a crossroads, how to pay the fees, or whether or not to pay the fees, because you're not getting value for money and you are at a crossroad. But I pray for wisdom to prevail even in this time. And we pray the strength of the parents, Lord, that we too will understand the devices, so that we can help our children and to monitor them and to help them in this time. So we pray for the parents, we pray for the children, we pray for our nation's children tonight. We pray for the children across the world. Yes, God, even Latanya with her two boys, we place them in your hands tonight, mighty God. And we pray that you would just order their steps. And Lord, we know Latanya is always helping her boys, oh God, with their study. But I pray for an incense, oh God, strength upon her life and wisdom, Lord, that she'll be able to do it with a spirit of excellence, and that her boys will excel in every area of their lives. Father, we want to thank you tonight for everyone. For those who have forgotten their names to call them, we pray, Lord, that you will not, oh God, fail to remember them. Even for Beverly Rose, oh God, as she has joined.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord, we place her in your hands tonight. And I pray that she will come to the point of saying, I surrender all. Yes, God, I pray that she will not hold on to the things that are not of you. She will be willing to let them go tonight and say, I surrender all. All to Jesus. I surrender all to you, Lord, we freely give. So, Lord, help Beverly tonight. Yes, Lord. And I pray, Lord, for just about everyone who have listened tonight, everyone who have shared in this study tonight. Bless them, we pray.
Yes,
bless,
Lord,
the church family. For those who are not able to join us in this way, we pray for them. Even our new converts, I saw Shirley Brown who have joined us. Yes, God, I pray for their strength tonight. And I pray, God, that you would keep them safe. Yes, God, and that their faith will not waver in this time, but that, God, they will continue to keep their eyes upon you. And when they feel like giving up, help them, oh God, that they will call upon you, and that, God, they will seek even our support, Lord, because we are here to help them and to encourage them. So, Lord, just be there for our new believers. Yes, God, and just help them, Lord, edge them in. Let no distraction come their ways. And when the enemy comes in like a flood, we pray, Lord, that the Holy Spirit will continue to lift up a standard against him,
yes,
and to cause them to continue to endure.
We beg,
oh God, we bundle them before you tonight, and we pray for their faith that it will continue to soar, and that, God, they will continue to keep, oh God, pressing on and not being discouraged. Hallelujah. We bundle them before you tonight and just say thanks for their lives in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Yes, Lord. We pray for those who have not been able to join us, Lord. Yes, God, the elderly and those who are not on Facebook access, Lord, that you will help them in their crisis. You will help them wherever they are. And help us, oh God, that as a family, we'll continue to reach out and give support and encouragement, because we know that we are called to be examples in this present time. So bless us, we pray. We put our nation in your hands, mighty God. We put, oh God, our leadership, the leadership of our country. We pray for unity among the ministries and the government. Yes, God, and the opposition, and that they will work together for the good of the land. And that, God, you'll continue to just pour out your wisdom upon them, that they will lead aright. And whatever they do, it will be according to your will, in the name of Jesus. So thank you, Lord, for everyone tonight, even for Howard, my friend who has joined us, and just about everyone, Brother Riley. We just give you thanks, Lord, for them in the name of Jesus. And we claim victory tonight, and we claim strength to carry us along in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Bless the Lord. So thanks to one. Thanks to all for sharing tonight. And, you know, as you go through tonight, want to just remember that as Christians, we are called to be responsible at this time. We are called to live our lives in a way that we will help others who don't know better, that we, you know, will be there to point them to the light, and we'll continue to, you know, lead others to Christ by the way we model Christ. So we're going to be closing with this song, Carry Your Candle, background music that is. And as you go, I want you to bear this song in mind tonight. Let me just get back this computer up. Yes. So I'm going to be doing the benediction, and you know, if you are able to stay for the song, you can, but those who can stay for the rest of the song, this thing is pausing for a while. Yes, right, just coming up. Good. Yes. So for those who can stay for the song, I would welcome you to do that. But for those who you do have to leave, we understand. And so the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen. Both now and forevermore. Thank you, Joe and Caden. Yes, that the Lord will cover the Williams family under his blood and to strengthen us in the name of Jesus. Really appreciate that. So, and I also see Janet making her comment, which I didn't highlight. Yes, thanks for sharing, Janet. And, you know, we look forward for greater synergy and you know, collaboration as we go forward. So please be blessed by this song as we close. God bless you all. It has started. My music. You must not do things that you're not to do. See the remote here? Just bear with me, please. Some dark and cold.
There is a spirit who brings a fire, ignites a candle, and makes it his own. So carry your candle.
into the darkness, seek out the homeless, confuse their door. Hold out your candle for all to see it. Take your candle, go light your word. Take your candle, go light your word. Frustrated brother, see how he's trying to light his own candle some other way. See now your sister, she's been robbed and lied to, still holds a candle without a flame. Tarry your candle, run to the darkness, seek out the lonely, the tired and worn. Hold out your candle for all to see it. Take your candle, go light your word. Take your candle, go light your word. So let's raise our candles and light up the skies. Pray to our Father in the name of Jesus. Make us a beacon in darkest times.
Bless you all. Please remember that we are light, we are beacons, and we must continue to shine. God bless you. We must be an example to the world. We must respect the authority, the rule that is set over us. God help us as we do so. Have a good rest of the night. The Lord blesses you. Amen.